In addition to defining the notion of a language itself, we want to define some operations on languages and establish some notation. We'll illustrate using these two languages over the 0-1 alphabet. Since languages are sets, we have the usual operations of union, intersection, and complement. For example, A union B consists of these three strings: 0 from both A and B, 10 from A, and 11 from B. The intersection contains only those strings in both languages, just the string 0 here. To define the complement of a language, we need to make clear what it is that we're completing. It's not sufficient just to say that it's everything not in A. For this particular A, that would include strings with characters besides 0 and 1, or maybe even infinite sequences of zeros and ones, which we don't want. The complement, therefore, is designed so as to complete the set of all strings over the relevant alphabet, in this case, the binary alphabet. Usually, the alphabet over which the language is defined will be clear from context. In this case, the complement of A will be infinite, including the empty string, not 0, however. It will include 1, it will include 0, 0, it will include 0, 1, it will not include 10, however, it will include 11, it will include 0, 0, 0, and so on and so forth for all longer strings. In addition to these standard set operations, we also define an operation for concatenating two languages. The concatenation of A and B is just all strings that you can form by taking a string from A, let's say X, and appending to it a string Y from B. In our examples, the set AB would be 0, 0, the first 0 coming from A, and the second from B, 0, 1, 1, with the 0 coming from A, and the 1, 1 coming from B, and so forth. Of course, we can also concatenate a language with itself, as I've done here in this example. Instead of writing AA, we often write A squared, and in general, when we want to concatenate a language with itself k times, we write A to the kth power. Note that for k equals 0, this is defined as the language containing exactly the empty string. When we want to concatenate any number of strings from a language together to form a new language, we use an operator known as clean star. This can be thought of as the union of all possible powers of the language. When we want to exclude the empty string, we use the plus operator instead, which insists that at least one string from A be used. Notice the difference in the starting indices. So, for example, this string here is in A star. There's a way that I can break it up so that each part is in the language A. Note that A star doesn't include infinite sequences of symbols. Each individual string from A must be a finite length, and you're only allowed to concatenate a finite number of those together. For those who have studied regular expressions, this should seem quite familiar. In fact, one gets the notation for regular expressions by treating individual symbols as languages. For example, 0 star is the set of all strings consisting entirely of zeros. We'll also commonly refer to sigma star, meaning all possible strings over the alphabet sigma.